There's a controversy going on in Malaysia right now over a planned investment deal that would give BlackRock a share in running Malaysia's airports. Now let's talk about BlackRock itself for a moment. BlackRock is the world's largest asset manager. When BlackRock makes a move, entire economies feel the ripple. This is the economic clout that translates directly into political power. You know, during the COVID-19 pandemic, the United States Federal Reserve called upon none other than BlackRock to manage its corporate bond buying program. So this isn't just influence that BlackRock has, it's control. And the story is the same in Europe. You know, the European Central Bank turned to, again, BlackRock for advice on its asset purchase program. Larry Fink, BlackRock's CEO, has cultivated close relationships with key political figures, with key political leaders. There's a revolving door between BlackRock and the highest levels of government. This isn't just influence, it's infiltration, it's capture. They're constantly working behind the scenes. BlackRock is constantly at work, trying to mold the laws and mold the policies that affect every aspect of the lives of Americans and Westerners and people around the world. And they want to colonize our countries. They want to colonize our economies, just as they did in the past. This is just a modern form of imperialism, if we let them get away with it, where they can have just the few dictate the terms to the many. We have to recognize and we have to understand this reality, this new reality of economic imperialism, and deal with it strategically. We need to build bridges with our brothers and sisters in the global south, in Africa, in Asia, in Latin America, in the Arab world, and in the Muslim world. And that, quite honestly, in my opinion, is what I think that Malaysia and Abu Dhabi are actually doing with this deal. I believe that this deal is strategic. And rather than BlackRock being allowed to dominate, I believe that this deal has the potential to actually rein BlackRock in, together in solidarity with other Muslim nations and with other nations of the global south. We can finally, potentially contain this behemoth. Together, we can reclaim our collective sovereignty, and we have to do it together to ensure that power will lie with the people, with our nations, and not with corporate giants like BlackRock. But we can't do that in an openly confrontational way. Look, we're at a critical juncture in our history where the forces of economic power are shifting from the global north to the global south, and the global south stands, as I've said many times, at the threshold of an unprecedented opportunity. This deal between the Abu Dhabi Investment Authority, ADIA, Malaysia Airports Holding Berhad, and BlackRock, I think potentially has a very significant ramifications for our future. Let's make one thing clear. As I said, BlackRock is a behemoth in the financial world, in the economic world, in the private sector. They manage $9 trillion in assets. This company has the power to influence economies, to make or break markets. For too long, we've seen such power as BlackRock used as an instrument of economic colonization, stripping resources from the global south to feed the insatiable appetite of Western interests. But here's the brilliance, in my opinion, of what ADIA and MAHB are doing. They've struck a deal that gives BlackRock a stake in Malaysia's airports while restricting the extent of that stake. This isn't about surrendering control, it's about leveraging power strategically. By bringing BlackRock into the fold, in my opinion, they're not just inviting investment. They're forging a partnership that aligns BlackRock's interests with the stability and the prosperity of Malaysia and the Muslim world and the Global South more broadly. I mean, look at the bigger picture. The United Arab Emirates and Saudi Arabia are already partnering with BlackRock in a number of areas, in various capacities. Their partnerships are from areas of infrastructure, renewable energy, financial services, on and on and on. And this is important because when BlackRock has vested interests in the success of the Muslim world when its profitability is tied to the prosperity of our regions, it becomes a partner rather than a predator. The stability and the growth of the Middle East, Asia, and Africa, and Latin America become integral to BlackRock's own success, to their own profitability. This creates a powerful incentive for BlackRock to actually support policies and to support initiatives and projects and so on that foster stability, that foster growth and prosperity in our countries. The global economy is pivoting, as I've talked about many, many times. The center of gravity is shifting from the West towards Asia, Africa, and the Middle East. These regions are poised to become, in my opinion, the new engines of global economic growth. By aligning with BlackRock, ADIA and MAHB are ensuring that this economic giant has a stake in our collective success so that it won't try and take it through hostility and aggression. They're transforming a potential adversary into an ally. This isn't just about airports and investments, no. It's about redefining relationships with Western power. It's about ensuring that the instruments of global finance, the levers of the global economy, work for us and not against us. By carefully managing the extent of BlackRock's stake, ADIA and MAHB retain control and sovereignty while still benefiting from the financial and strategic support that BlackRock can provide. In my opinion, this deal is a lesson in strategic empowerment. It's a blueprint for how we can navigate this global transition without losing our autonomy. It's about understanding that power, when strategically harnessed, can be a force for liberation rather than subjugation. You know, last year, I talked about my reservations regarding BRICS and regarding the pivot of the global economy to the global south. And I said that the issue was never about whether or not that pivot would take place, but how it would take place, how it would happen, how it would be managed, and whether or not our countries would be able to recalibrate their approach to Western institutions and to foreign investment and Western power, recalibrate their own image of the West and of themselves so that they could actually steer the process of the economic pivot. And in my opinion, that's exactly what Malaysia, the UAE, and Saudi Arabia are doing. By making a deal like this, they're defanging the wolf. By establishing partnerships with BlackRock, they are recruiting BlackRock's political power to serve the interests of our own nations, of our own people. They're giving them a reason and they're giving them an incentive to actually cooperate in our prosperity and our security. And I think that's very wise. And I also think that this is much better and more intelligent as a way to support the Palestinians. The more that the owners and controllers of global financialized capital, the more they care about their relationships with us, the more leverage we have. So I think that opposing this deal on the basis of BlackRock's, I mean, particularly on the basis of BlackRock's Israeli interests, I think that's very short-sighted and misguided. Because the reality is that the opportunities that partnership with the Muslim world provides or presents to BlackRock, those opportunities easily eclipse any interests that they could possibly have with the Israelis. And thus, the more influence we have over BlackRock, because of those opportunities and investment opportunities that we provide them, the more influence then we will then have over the Israelis. Whereas if we were to shun partnerships like this and strategic alliances like this, we do nothing but exclude ourselves from having any influence whatsoever, and that doesn't help the Palestinians at all. And Allahu A'lam.